A hacker gained access to more than 100 million Capital One customers' accounts and credit card applications. Paige Thompson is accused of breaking into a Capital One server and gaining access to 140,000 social security numbers, 1 million Canadian social insurance numbers, 80,000 bank account numbers. She also accessed an undisclosed number of names, addresses, credit scores, credit limits, and balances. The 33-year-old was arrested Monday in connection with this breach. The FBI special agent who investigated Thompson believes she tweeted that she wanted to distribute these social security numbers along with full names and dates of birth, looking for a market. According to the Department of Justice, Thompson had worked as a tech company software engineer for the cloud hosting company that Capital One was using. Now, Capital One says the hack happened March 22nd, March 23rd. It found it and fixed the vulnerability, adding the largest category of information accessed, credit card applications from 2005 through early 2019. Now, the bank says no credit card numbers or login information were compromised. Thompson's attorney could not be immediately reached for comment, and Capital One said it will notify you. If you were affected by the breach, it's going to notify you. It will make free credit monitoring and ID protection available. The bank, Allison, is still investigating the incident. How many times now has the typical consumer been offered free credit monitoring because the people with our information can't keep it safe?
We have an update now on breaking news out of northern Mississippi. Sheriff's deputies in DeSoto County, Mississippi, say at least two people are now dead. This in an early morning shooting at a Walmart. Our Nick Valencia joins us now with breaking developments. Also reports of a police officer down. Is that right?
That's right, Jim. Here we have very limited information at this hour. This is still a very fluid situation, a developing situation. But here is what our assignment desk has been able to confirm so far. Two people were shot dead at a Walmart in South Haven, Mississippi. DeSoto County Sheriff Bill Rasko tells CNN an officer responding to the shooting and the suspect were both shot in the early morning incident and are being treated at nearby hospitals. There are several responding agencies, including South Haven Police, as well as the County Sheriff's Department. They evidently have secured the area, and the investigation into the cause of the shooting is ongoing. According to local affiliate reporting, this shooting happened around 6:30 or 6:45 at the Walmart store there off Southcrest Parkway on Goodman Road. This is, as I mentioned, still a developing situation here, and we're working on getting more information, but this is what we can tell you. Two dead in a shooting early this morning at a Mississippi Walmart.
When you think of the $13 billion a year diamond mining business, you may think of Africa, which is home to 65% of the industry. You may even think of conflict diamonds, also known as blood diamonds. Those are illegally traded diamonds that fund wars. I guarantee you don't think of Arkansas. But here in the small town of Murfreesboro is the only public diamond mine in the world.
People come here every year to search for diamonds. You're a part of the history of this place whenever you set foot in this volcano.
For more than a century, this volcanic crater has been producing diamonds. The first diamond was found here in 1906 by a farmer named John Wesley Huddleston.
He took his stones to a bank in Murfreesboro, and the teller, you know, offered him 50 cents for them. And he said, no, they're diamonds, and I've got a whole field full of them.
37 and a half acres to be exact, and I was determined to find one.
Those large diamonds found.
A lot of people find them just laying on top of the ground. And all that requires is a pair of eyes and rain. Most of our visitors find diamonds using equipment like this, though.
Are you looking for a big diamond or a better chance to find any diamond?
Oh, that's a good question. Yeah. Can it be both?
Right, well, hopefully.
The largest diamond ever found here was 40.23 carats. That was in 1924, when this land was owned by Arkansas Diamond Mining Company. In 1972, it was taken over by the state and is now a state park.
First thing you can do is just start washing out that loose dirt, just shaking it up and down. You can use your hands. Mm-hmm. The colorful gravel in the center will be where your diamond is most likely to be.
Oh, what is that?
Diamonds are never wet or dirty. So what you're looking at here is a piece of quartz.
Oh, is this just a tourist trap? Are you just charging people money to go out and walk around aimlessly and come back empty-handed?
Not at all. Now, the chances are that you may not find a diamond your first time out here, but we have one to two diamonds found here every day.
Almost 100,000 diamonds have come from just these 37 acres. Right. And how much money is that? How much are we talking?
Yeah,
millions.
Millions, yeah.
How much longer will this crater be able to produce diamonds for people to look for?
Well, it's not going to run out anytime soon. This deposit that people are digging in today goes at least 600 feet deep. 100 years from now or more, we'll still be finding diamonds here. You don't have to go online, you don't have to go to a jewelry store, and you can find something like this with your own hands.